Welcome in, everybody. It's the coach. This is Madden 20 on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles as they take on a man back for a 16th NFL season, Eli Manning and the New York Football Giants. I'll be back with you again with scores around the league at halftime. But kickoff right around the corner. And standing by to call the action, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, we welcome everybody to the Garden State. EA Sports coverage of the NFL finds us at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. This is the scene just before we came on air. This New York crowd fired up by the arrival of their G-men as they burst from the locker room. They're ready to go as the Giants get set to match up with Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles. Alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you take a look at this Giants ball club. They come in just in an absolute free fall, losers of seven in a row.
And this is where you turn to your best players and look at them and say, can you guide us out of this? We've got to be better than what we've shown.
Meanwhile, for our visitors, the Eagles, it's late in the year. We all know it. We've seen the calendar for these guys. Their bodies could probably use a break, but they have to push on.
And they're really not as worried about that as maybe we think. They know they've got the entire offseason to rest. All they care about is the game in front of them and finishing strong.
Teams here playing for pride as the final week of the NFL season is underway. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Carson Wentz in his fourth season now out of North Dakota State, ready to bring out this Eagles offense. And he's had to sit and watch Nick Foles under center during Philly's last two playoff runs. So health will be a key for Wentz in 2019, no doubt.
I'm coming after you.
A little jet sweep to start the drive. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Wentz off the fake handoff to Howard. He's got his man on the crossing route. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 17 yards and a first down for Philly. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Wentz now to throw. And he will find his man on the outside. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Here's the offense, and sometimes you got to show love to the big guys.
That you do. And we're talking about Jason Kelce now, not Travis, his brother who plays tight end. Jason lines up at center, a threat to go to the Pro Bowl each and every year.
Second and five after the 5 yard completion on first down. Now a two-time 1,000-yard rusher for the Bears. This is Jordan Howard. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 10 yards there and an Eagle first down. A good run by Jordan Howard. And now another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. This will be a 2 yard loss on the play. And that'll make it second and 12. At the 38 yard line. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. Oh, jumping early from his tight end spot. Maybe trying to get a jump start on that route.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that. And oftentimes when you see that, that means the play call was supposed to come in his direction, and he was eager to go catch a pass.
The throw by Wentz, caught by Jackson. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 25-yard line.
It's a gain of 17 yards.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in this paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Now Howard. He's able to work free for about six down to the 18. And this will be play number eight of the opening drive. It's third and short. Now Wentz on the bootleg. Going to go to Clement here out of the backfield. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. They moved the ball pretty well there on the opening drive. You think they're okay settling for three?
I don't think they're happy about settling for three, but I think you're exactly right with the word okay, because they threw it well, they ran it well. Excellent balance for the first drive of the game.
Fielded about a yard deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. So here are the Giants under second-year coach Pat Shurmur. They'll be led out by the veteran quarterback, a multiple-time Pro Bowler. It's, of course, Eli Manning.
He had the numbers of a game last week that if you win, you talk about him being a gritty guy, managing the game, getting it done. But they lost. So obviously, two interceptions, one touchdown pass, that's not going to be good enough. Got to get that changed around.
Here's a throw, complete right side to start things out. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. First down for the Giants as they pick up 12. Faking the give to Barkley, now Manning. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Holding. Let's get the call. They were looking to throw, holding on the big right tackle.
That's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide. You're usually going to pick up a holding call.
A loss of two there. Second down.
A loss of two brings up second down.
Check.
22-yard line.
Check. 42's the mic. You got me dripping.
Throwing on second and long. Manning. That's caught. It's Coleman. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. And the offensive starters for the New York Giants.
And we focus on maybe the ultimate home run hitter in the NFL today, and that's running back Saquon Barkley, because teams come into every game with the idea that they want to limit his production and especially his big play ability. But how many times did we watch him in his rookie year where he would be limited throughout the game, and then all of a sudden, there he goes out the back door, 50, 60, 70 yards. He's a lot of fun to watch unless you're trying to defend him. But that's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. The Eagles offense making their way back out as we take a look at the playoff picture in the NFC. And it's all come down to this, hasn't it? Final week of the regular season. As this year's playoffs play out anything like the regular season has gone, could be in for a wild and fun month of January.
And we can break the rules because we can look ahead. All right, there's not a coach out there that's ever said to their team, all right, let's look three weeks down the road. It's always right here, right now. Forget that. Think about what the playoffs are going to look like. The teams that we see that are already in, the teams that are trying to get in, we could have some great matchups.
And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. He lost two there, and it's third down.
I think there's one element that just keeps increasing on defense in the NFL, and that's speed. They wanted it every position, and we just saw there some linebackers who can go sideline to sideline, run past that trash, go past people, and make tackles near the sidelines.
Not only near the sideline, but also in the backfield there for the loss. Now the throw on third down, knocked away and incomplete.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past. The biggest teaching point, get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. The Giants' offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. You know, Charles, season winding down, time to maybe look ahead to the offseason. What do you see these guys going after, either in the draft or free agency?
Well, with the season that they're having, just about every position is up for grabs right now. No one is really safe, but the focal point's always the quarterback position. And he may be auditioning to try and stay with his own current team. I think he's auditioning for the rest of the league to try and find a spot, because I think this team is looking for a new quarterback.
A throw over the middle, taken in, and able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup. A lot of people thinking that this could be a good year for Sterling Shepard to step out of the shadows of Odell Beckham Jr. But a season ago, pretty good for Sterling Shepard. 66 receptions, 872 yards, and now hoping for a 1,000-yard campaign in 2019. Manning on target here to Shepard. First down for the Giants as they pick up 12. The numbers for Shepard in last week's game. Unfortunately, his effort not enough to help put him over the hump in that defeat.
And let's face it, this is a guy who absolutely hates.
Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line.
I spent a lot of extra time preparing for this game, watching this offensive line, because they gave up 5 sacks last week in their loss. They just gave up another one now. They don't seem to be working together as a cohesive unit, right? 4 guys might have it right, but the 5th guy is giving something up. They've got to find a way to all get on the same page.
To try again after the sack, Manning. He was looking for Evan Engram, the tight end. And it'll bring up 3rd down. For the Eagles, a look now at the starters on the defensive side of the ball. It's quite a unit, that's for sure. Number 1 in the NFL against the pass.
Yeah, defending the pass hasn't been an issue for them. It's been stopping the run. And if they don't stop the run, they can't get back to their strength, which is guarding against the air attack.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Now Manning. Well, the 2 men come together, and it's incomplete. Excellent work defensively, brings up 4th down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. Remember with Rosas, there was some speculation last year in the preseason that he might not hold on to his job with the Giants.
But he certainly answered the challenge, didn't he? 32 of 33 during the regular season, 97% that is, and was named to the NFC Pro Bowl team. And by the way, at 6'3", 234, he can bench press your kicker.
Then he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive, and they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
7 yards there and a 1st down.
The tackle made by DeAndre Baker. A gain of 7.
On play action, Wentz. And this one hauled in by Will Tye. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. Right about 20 yards on the pickup. And officially, they'll say it's going to go for 19. Catch number 100 for his career right there, and it's good enough to keep the chains moving. Wentz now on 1st down. Gets this to his running back, Jordan Howard. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Call that a very strong gain of 24. On the delay, it's Howard. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Michael Thomas on the stop. And this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Brings up second and five. Keep it up. At the 11-yard line.
3-3, a tight one after one on EA Sports. Second and five now. Wentz, and he slings one that's incomplete. He was trying to find DeSean Jackson that time, and it's third down. They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. To throw, it's Wentz. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete. DeAndre Baker, the first corner chosen in this year's draft, there to make the play defensively. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get the third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game.
Now a hit and a loose football. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And a super return as he gets us all the way down inside the 25-yard line. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy, because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
A quick pass out to Aguilar.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there? Swarming to it and not allowing that to happen. Did not let him get downfield.
On second down now. It's Howard, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9.
Here we go, here we go.
It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Shotgun now for Wentz. This is taken in by Jeffrey. He's got it. Touchdown, Eagles. Alshon Jeffrey. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Eagles able to push further out in front.
I wonder if he changed anything on his play sheet or they just executed better. Because they had two previous drives that ended in field goals. Before this one, they finally were able to put into the end zone.
Well, whatever he did, speaking of the offensive coordinator, might be using that formula going forward. It worked there.
It worked very well. He and his field general in pretty good sync right now. They're starting to move the ball well.
Wentz's pass complete to Alshon Jeffrey. Touchdown, Philadelphia.
They had to go to the monitor, get an extra look. That's what the technology is for. And this touchdown will count. Elliott good on the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So they only needed three plays on that drive. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. As the Giants head back out there, let's take a look at the playoff picture in the NFC. They're in a 13-3 hole here now as they come up on first down. Manning and the Giants come up now first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. Manning going to hand it off to Barkley. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. Well, that's something we saw over and over again in Barkley's rookie season. He had 91 catches last year, most ever by a rookie running back. Part of a fantastic rookie campaign that saw him go over 2,000 total yards. And across the midfield stripe into Eagle territory. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. From just shy of midfield, Manning under pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line. Brandon Graham in there to get him, and that is now sack number 18 on the season for him. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Throwing is Manning on third down. Finding his target, it's Cody Latimer. And he gets it just shy of midfield, but that's not enough. He's short of the marker. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down. Dixon, the punter, is on as he sends it away. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. The passing game, they've had more success there than the running game. Maybe something they game plan for.
How come they didn't tell us about it?
Because they wanted to keep it a secret.
We did ask, didn't we? But I think what happened in this one is they've realized that they've established the run pretty well, and teams are going to key on that. They thought they could open it up and have success through the air, and that's exactly what's going on.
Yeah, they've had success at least so far here in the second quarter. And he'll get 2, maybe 3 up near the 37. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. They run with Howard. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. The Eagles on third down. 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be 3rd and 6. Wentz going to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, 1st and 10 at the 49-yard line. A pretty good-looking run there on first down. That'll go for 9 yards, just short of the line to gain. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
A run, it's Clement. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. From the 27, Wentz. And he finds his tight end. It's Ertz. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3.
The beauty of route running is it doesn't matter what position. Everyone's doing the same thing. In this case, tight end selling the vertical route. Get the defensive back on his heels, break off for the corner. With good timing, you get a completion, as we just saw there.
A carry here for the big tight end. And he will take this one in for an Eagle touchdown. Dallas Goedert, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles able to push further out in front.
That score was not a game clincher by any stretch of the imagination. But the other team now has to be careful to not let this game begin to slip away.
Elliott on for the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game as the lead moves to 17.
Score, Eagles 20,
So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The Giants' offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. It's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
From the 35 on second down, Manning. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Brandon Graham in there for the sack, and he's closing in on the all-time record. That's number 19 on the year.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been under constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game.
We got double up.
On third down, Manning. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Manning's pass intended for Sterling Shepard.
Sometimes it's just not your day. There's another failure right there on third down.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Oh, leaves him behind on the spin. Now a hit and a loose football. And the Giants have it. It's picked up. And this is taken into the end zone. A fumble recovery and a Giants touchdown. They haven't fully climbed the mountain, but they've started the ascent here with that score.
I like that, right? I think they've left base camp now, okay?
Go.
So they've started to move their way up the mountain. Long way to go, but at least they know it's manageable.
Aldrich Rosas on for the extra point. It's up. It's good. That'll make the score line 20-10. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for 6. This is taken at the 3. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
This is Howard on second down. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. The Eagles on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This will be 3rd and 6. Throwing now is Wentz. And Jeffrey's got it. And he will have a first down here at about the 40.
That's it,
Jeffrey. An 8-yard pickup.
That's a pretty good throw on the curl route there. 3rd down, and they pick up a 1st.
Defense should be aware for that, right?
They should be aware, but it was so hard sometimes.
Yeah, it's not easy.
Because when they sell that route really well, you think they're going upfield, then they curl back, show their numbers to the quarterback, and complete the play.
It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. This pass complete, Wentz to Ertz. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a 3rd down. Now Wentz on 3rd down. And that will be incomplete.
And based on my math, They've only converted one time thus far in this game, so you can see the frustration starting to come out a little bit. Third downs, they've been a problem for them all game. They've got to start becoming solutions.
And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. 13 games going on here in this final Sunday of 2019, the final Sunday of the regular season. Three more games still to come following us. Raiders, Broncos, Cards, Rams, and Niners, Seahawks. And then we'll know the 12 teams who will continue on into the playoffs starting next Saturday here on EA Sports. Throwing again on second down, Manning. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a third and six. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. Not much going on this drive. Looks like they're going to have to punt it away, CD.
And right now, I know a lot of their fans are screaming for the OC to change things up, get away from what he's been calling. Sometimes you just need better execution of the plays that have been called.
It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. You've got under a minute to go here until halftime. You got the good size lead. No need to do anything crazy.
No, there really is no need to do anything crazy. The smart play, go ahead and take your lead into the...
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Carson Wentz with two first-half touchdown passes. And the Eagles able to push further out in front.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Elliott now to add the extra point. And that'll make this a three-score game as the lead moves to 17. And we can break that scoring drive down pretty easily. One play, long touchdown pass into the end zone. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
And this is Latimer, complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
Roughing the passer, defense.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Now, the first play of the drive there is incomplete. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41.
It's second down and 10.
To throw again, Manning. On the catch, this is Russell Shepard. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march up another 15 against your squad.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. The intended target, Saquon Barkley. And it's second down. Manning will try again on second down. And he's hit and taken down. Eli sacked. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. He hit his first. Now this from 43. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. Now it's scooped up, and this is alive. The big fella. He's at the 50. The 30. 20. 10. again. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. And Elliott puts this one through. And that will do it for this first half. So we've come upon halftime here in Week 17 as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, thank you as always. Welcome into our final regular season edition of our Halftime Report. Playoff lives hanging in...
And now due to apparent time constraints, we fast forward to the beginning of the second half. The final two quarters of the NFL regular season are upon us as the second half of Week 17 is underway. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a real,
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. To throw, it's Manning. And this is Shepard on the catch. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. The drive stays alive, a third down gain of 8. Manning now 9 of 17 through the year. Not a great percentage, but it is first and 10. Now Saquon Barkley. Tackle made that time by Brandon Graham. Manning to Barkley on the draw play. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Now it's Barkley, and Barkley did not get there. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a fourth and one.
I apologize in advance, partner, but the beef eaters on the interior of this D-line, you just know they were licking their chops on third and short. And yes, they were rewarded with a tasty dish, stuffing that one short of a first down.
Well, we got beef eaters licking their chops and tasty dish in one fell swoop.
I did apologize in advance, didn't I?
Yeah, you did. That line's not eating tofu, I'll tell you that much for free. On first down, Wentz. Caught by the tight end, Ertz. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. That throw good for 4. It's second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. Here's Wentz to throw. This short throw caught by Goddard. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the 20 at the 18. Now we'll get a stoppage here as it appears we've got an Eagle slow to get up. And this is certainly not what you want to see in the final week of the year. We'll be back.
Here we go. Waiting. All day, every day, any day.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. Ertz has it left side. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and 9. Running with Howard.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
From the gun on third down, Wentz. It's caught by Jackson. And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. And for an offense that is struggling, this is not where you want to start from. Great punt.
Fantastic punt. And for all those who wonder, what do punters...
And now the ball comes out. Manning lost it. And this will be recovered at least by the offense, but he'll be taken down in the end zone, and that is going to be a safety. And the safety there, another mistake, and these mistakes just keep piling up.
How many more can they make? They put themselves in such a massive hole now, going to be difficult to dig out from under.
Yeah, for sure, they can't afford any more at this point. Now the free kick comes after the safety from the 20 as they bring the punter on to try and get some hang time here. This is taken at the 23.
Here we go. Yeah.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Dalvin Tomlinson, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
Like how they've started the third quarter here. They forced a punt on the first drive, and after this sack, it looks like it'll be forcing another one as well.
Absolutely. Maybe got their second win coming out of the locker room. Eagles coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack. Now Wentz. He leaves this one for Howard, and he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. A loss of a yard, and it brings up four. A pass for negative yardage, obviously no good. Maybe he shouldn't have thrown it, or maybe he shouldn't have caught it.
I think we were seeing it at the same time, weren't we? Maybe you let that one go, right? Because you can see the lost yardage about to develop. But that goes against every instinct of a receiver. They're taught to catch everything. So it's really hard to be mad at him and yell at him for trying to make that play.
And for an offense that is struggling, this is not where you want to start from. Great punt.
Fantastic punt. And for all those who wonder, what do punters do during the course of practice each and every day? The best ones do what we just saw there. Work on positioning the football and helping their team.
They'll go to Barkley again. And just not much to be had there. 1 yard out to the 10. These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. Manning gonna throw. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's 4th down.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves them with a 2nd and 3. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So step off the 5 yards.
Yeah, partner, you know, defensive end, he wants to get into the offensive backfield. He wants that get off to be as fast as possible. A little too quick on that one.
Wentz now on first down. And he'll hit Jeffrey, complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 10 yards there and an Eagle first down. This is Jackson on the quick throw from Wentz. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18. That catch, by the way, number 542 in his NFL career, that draws him level with Lance Allworth, who was a Hall of Famer with the Chargers back in the 60s and 70s.
Yeah, the man they called Bambi. So if you're in that type of territory, catch the same number of passes he caught, you know you're on your way to a big-time career. And just think, he's not through yet.
Watch the slant.
Working from the gun, Wentz. His pass caught at the 4. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal. Looking to throw again on second down. Wentz feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7. Marcus Golden has now recorded 10 sacks on the season.
When you're this close to the goal line, you've got to expect pressure from the defense. So the ball's got to come out fast. Got to get out of his hands quicker.
So they're back at the 7 now for 3rd and goal. Wentz now to throw. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah,
what happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
So make him 4 out of 4 now in the field goal department, and he's able to extend their lead.
When drives have bogged down, he's been automatic out there. So nice to have a kicker you can count on to put points on the board.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Room here to run. The Red Sea parts, and there he goes. Touchdown, Giants. Saquon Barkley. 76 yards. And the Giants are able to cut into this lead. Well, if they're going to make a game of this in the second half, they need a few big plays to go their way. That's one.
And the way to get it done is to also conserve time. So to your point, that big play right there, now you're not moving the ball downfield, taking time off the clock. You're leaving yourself a better avenue to continue to try and make a comeback.
Rosas good with the extra point, and that'll cut the lead down to 18. It only took him 2 plays there to find the end zone. The last one, the long run, getting him in for 6 points. Now after the touchdown, here's Rosas on to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line.
Here we go.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're 3 scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in 2-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call 4-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
Yeah, they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
Roughing the passer, defense.
So a little extra on top of the big play there.
It's tough for guys rushing the passer, but you have to know when the ball is gone. And if you listen, officials will tell you ball's gone. He didn't pull up.
Catch is made by Arcega Whiteside. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. An excellent pickup of 20 yards. From the gun, it's Wentz. And it's caught. A gain of 7 that time. Second goal. Good yardage on first down. Now can they punch it in on second and goal? Now Wentz again. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. Welcome back now here in East Rutherford. It's the Eagles in possession of the football and leading this one as we get ready to start the final quarter. Now Wentz looking in zone, but it's incomplete.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive, and it was third and short, okay? They decide to throw the football incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit too hard about that play selection.
So yet another field goal to end a drive. That has been a very common theme. He's now hit five of them in this game.
Yeah, Brandon, as an offense, you hate that you've had to call on your kicker so often, but you have to love the fact that time and time again, he's come through.
And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
On the draw, this is Barkley. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. The Giants on third down. Just one conversion and eight tries. Not good. This is third and eight. Shotgun now for Manning. And that is incomplete. A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down.
Another incompletion. You know, it's a wonder he's still moving around back there the number of times he's been sacked.
Yeah, he's staying out there, isn't he? And you don't think about it much in a game like this, but he's showing incredible leadership. Still competing, still fighting, not taking himself out of a ball game that appears lost.
Well, at this stage of the game in the second half, down three scores, I guess they felt like they needed to push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, if they give up another score here after they didn't get it, does it really matter?
Right.
It really doesn't. They had to go and try and make something happen if they had any chance of winning this game.
10 yards there and an Eagle first down. On first, they go right back to Howard. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
The last run got six, now second and four.
Wentz gonna throw, and he finds his tight end, it's Ertz. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. An Eagle first down there, Wentz to Ertz, and the names that end in TZ. Trying to punch it in with Howard. And he will take this one in for an Eagle touchdown. Jordan Howard, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. Second effort there. He was determined to find pay dirt, and he did.
I think that's a great example of what coaches talk about, a back that runs behind his pads, and he uses pads to get him into the end zone.
Elliott good with a PAT, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So that drive, four plays, and finishing it off with a touchdown run was Jordan Howard. This fielded a few yards into the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned it to 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do.
And he's hit and taken down. Eli sacked. Nigel Bradham flying in and laying the lumber defensively.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
Now they're in some hot water now. After that sack, it's second and 21. Throwing is Manning. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete.
The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. From the gun on third down, Manning. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And no return on this one as that kick's out of bounds, so they'll start just outside of their own 30-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on three games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. These guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game. And that's always puzzled me a little bit.
So some holding over on the left side of that O-line.
And I know for the guys trying to move those big defensive people, they'd love for them to stay in one spot. But they move around so quick and so fast that sometimes you just have to grab them.
And this winds up a gain of four to the 41. 4 yards on the pickup. It'll be second down. On second down, it's Howard. The Eagles on third down, just a 20% success rate at 2 of 10. This will be third and five. From midfield, here's Wentz. And he connects with Ertz. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 25-yard line. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way. It worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Let's go. Hey, alert three. Alert three.
On first down, they run with Howard. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. 14 yards there and an Eagle first down.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Three touchdown passes now for Carson Wentz as his guys continue to put this one out of reach.
And now we've hit that stage of the game, partner, where one of our predecessors, one of the great commentators of all time, he's to sing in this situation when this game appeared to be over.
I know the fat lady's been singing for some time.
No, not her at all. This is
but
one of our guys.
She's singing too.
Oh, she's singing. She's
on like the fifth tune at
this
point.
Yeah, she left scales way behind. But he's to sing something about turning out the lights. The party was over.
Elliott good on the extra point, and that will extend this big lead. So this drive spans seven plays, and it was capped off by an Eagles touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Face mask. Defense.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
He had a great move, but he'll still be stopped shy of midfield. 4 yards on the pickup, and that'll make this a second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. The Giants on third down, not getting the job done at all. A very poor 1-for-10. This will be 3rd and 6. And Ingram hauls it in. And he has another first down as he'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 37. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 37-yard line. Again, it's Manning. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Fletcher Cox with sack number 23 on the year, breaking Michael Strahan's mark of 22 and a half. Congratulations.
Well, someone's closing in on the league lead in sacks. He came into the game in the top 5. Now you add 2 more to his total.
Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's 2nd and 18. Now Manning. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Derek Barnett in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
3rd and long for the Giants, and Eli following the sack. A delayed give to Gallman. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1. He already has 2 sacks to his credit. Now another tackle for loss.
And you know how you can always identify who was supposed to block him? They're the ones helping up the person who just got knocked to the ground with the ball, right? Whether it's a running play or a pass play, they've got to figure out a way to slow him down. Maybe you chip him with a second guy. Maybe you just out and out double him. Maybe you make sure you take the ball and throw it as far away from him as possible. Because right now, he is wrecking things for them.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Will tie the intended receiver, and that'll bring up 2nd down. To throw on 2nd and 10, Wentz. The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead. But I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense can crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it.
In trouble. And a most curious way there to burn some clock. That was wild. And at the end of all that, it winds up a safety. All right, Charles, help me out here. 4th quarter, you've got the lead, and you run backwards into the end zone. You're just trying to do too much.
I almost don't have words for it, but you know every coach that we talk to talks about running backs or people running the football, running north-south, getting upfield. He went way in the opposite direction, and that's going to cost his team.
Yeah, it cost him big time. Still leading, but it costs him. So after that safety, now a free kick situation forthcoming as they punt it away from the 20. And an alley to run! The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Now Manning finds his tight end Ingram.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer, defense.
Maybe a frustration penalty there because he's picked them apart.
They've tried their best to get to him and haven't done it successfully. A penalty as a result of that hit there.
This is Barkley, and they will only muster a yard here to the 38. Now we've got a Giant player here slow to get up after that last play. And this is certainly not what you want to see in the final week of the year. We'll be back. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine.
Six man. Check curls, check curls, check curls.
Working from the gun, Manning to the sideline, and it's caught, but boy, he's out of bounds. Now they tried to get him into space coming out of the backfield, but it'll be third down. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and nine. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. Another pass attempt, another incompletion. You figure defensively, you're in the fourth quarter here, you've held the team under 100 yards passing, you've done your job.
Especially in today's NFL, which is truly a pass-first league.
And that is no good. Oh, he missed it just wide of the upright. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at the 45. They go with Howard to begin the drive. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
One-yard gain brings up second and nine at the 46-yard line.
Oh, look at this. Wentz going to throw. Hits his target, the tight end, Will Tye.
Complete to number 51. He's a gain of a yard. And it's third down.
On third down, this is Howard. And he'll only get this to the 47. He needed a few more yards to pick up the first. A good gain there on third and 8 of 7 yards. And now a decision here on fourth and one. Here's Cameron Johnston now. He's been terrific so far. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Eagles, it will wind up a 500 season as the win means they'll finish right at 8-8. And by just about all accounts, not the type of year they were hoping to have. Meanwhile, for the Giants, it's been a sinking ship all season as they finally draw the curtain on what'll be a 1-15 year. And you have to figure that this is a team that will look a whole lot different come training camp next July. That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.